Minister of Health and Social Services Dr. Kalumbi Shangula said that the only time you cannot control individuals' behavior is at night.
During the day, and of course, when we take all these measures, you make a balance between prevention of the infection and also protecting livelihoods. You have to strike that balance. The economic activities, they are normally taking place during the day. And when these are taking place, there is an unregulated self-policing, so to say. If you are, during the day, if you are at work, you are either in your office and you don't have an opportunity to go and socialize. So you do activity which is aimed at economic promotion. Now, why are the curfew after hours? During after hours is when a person has got the freedom to socialize. It's when they go to visit. During the day you don't visit anybody because everybody else is busy. In the evening after work, you go and visit. You go into the entertainment places. You are not staying home. The president made it absolutely clear that one of the most important things is the appeal he made is for people to stay at home. Now the curfew is exactly doing that.
The Justice Minister added that many people are still violating the COVID-19 regulations despite the increase in positive cases.
We have noticed that there's been a lot of pressure on our justice sector infrastructure, particularly prisons and police stations and so forth. We are currently looking at whether there are alternative ways that we can introduce to address the concern of having people congest at police stations or in prison cells. That's something that we are working on. In the meantime, we are encouraging the Namibian public to simply comply with the regulations, and then we don't have to put so much pressure on the activities that relates to particularly maintenance of law and order in general to the operation of the Namibian police. And I want to just indicate that we notice that the regular interventions relate to the sale of alcohol. People are now, particularly between Fridays and Sundays, people are using camouflage such as butcheries to continue to sell alcohol. And the Namibian police have noticed that this is the case. So we are making a distinction between mourners and service providers at the funerals. And that really means those that provide a service, such as a pastor, for example, would not be included in the 10-person requirement. People still continue to find reasons to travel, and we want to encourage the Namibian public to please do every effort, unless it's really, really important for you to travel. We've indicated it's essential service, it's people who have an emergency, mainly medical emergencies, or an emergency that is life-threatening, and of course, we people who go and bury their parents, their siblings, not aunties and uncles and all of those other things. We understand that sometimes these situations are complex, but we do want to encourage you, please, to try and stay away from traveling if you are able to do so.
The health minister is encouraging the Namibian nation to stay safe and prevent infection by following the regulations.